Welcome back to Strange Love Live's coverage of Open Source Bridge. We're going to wrap up in a few minutes, but before we do, we've got Donnie Burkholz, at dburkholz on Twitter. Mm-hmm. And you just came from your talk, Assholes Are Killing My Project, Killing Your Project, Everybody's Project, or Assholes Killing Your Project, because we've had some asshole problems lately around here.
Indeed. I think it's a problem common to a lot of places, and most people don't really appreciate the value of the culture. Mm-hmm. But it's something that's really important, and I'm just trying to get that across to everybody else. And in my project, it's a huge problem.
What's your project?
Gentoo Linux. Yeah, so our Linux distribution, and we've got about 250 contributors right now. Mm-hmm. And about five of those are the outliers that are just killing us.
Do they know which five they are?
Oh, yes.
They know who they are.
Yeah, and it's really challenging to get people to leave a volunteer in an open project. Mm-hmm. Right? Because you can try to kick them out, but you can't force them to leave.
Because it's volunteer.
Yeah, it's volunteer, it's open. I mean, there's a chat room for this, right? There's mailing lists for Gentoo. And if you remove their commit access, they can come back and be on the mailing list. If you ban them, they can join with a different name. Mm-hmm. And you have to get it to the point where somehow they want to leave.
So how do you keep the assholes from killing your project? How do you get them to leave?
That's a great question. And getting them to leave is actually very challenging. It's a lot easier to stop the problem when it's small, mm-hmm. right? By just creating this sort of framework that makes it very difficult for assholes to get involved in your project. Once they're there already,
I see it like a cancer.
Mm-hmm. So you have to take drastic action, you know, pull out the scalpel, cut it out, chemotherapy, and then afterwards, you know, the whole project is a little bit weaker for a while, but it'll recover and be healthier than ever.
So how did your interest in a-holes, I'm reading the card verbatim here, he censored the last part.
I don't censor.
Kelly censored. How did your interest in assholes start?
It started because, I mean, it's just a problem that's so close to home. Mm-hmm. And Gentoo Linux is something I care about very deeply. And so when it started being destroyed, I wanted to learn more about, you know, what's happening. And I know exactly what's happening, but why is it happening and how do I stop it from happening? And it turns out that, well, stopping it's tough. And we've tried to kick people out, and some of them are still around, and we still haven't figured out how to get rid of them.
So it's an ongoing process.
It's an ongoing process. That's why they are killing your project, and they haven't killed it yet.
How did the talk go?
It's hard to say. I think it went well, but I didn't get many questions. So either I said everything people wanted to know, or they were sleeping.
Well, they were sticking around afterwards. Yeah.
They were
still
well attended. We had to switch the room that you were in to give you enough room for everyone who wanted to come.
Yeah, I was disappointed. I was hoping for a very cozy room, but then it was very spacious afterwards.
We have cozy. We've got cozy.
Yeah, we've got cozy.
Now you can have cozy. How did you get involved in open source, and how long have you been working with it?
I got involved with open source for the first time in college. Mm-hmm. And I'm actually not a computer person for my day job. I'm a biochemist. Mm-hmm. And what we do is we simulate molecules on computers. Turns out that a lot of the programs to do that run on Linux. So that's how I got started using it. And then over time, I just got more and more involved in the community aspects of it because I really like the community. And I started using Gentoo because I'd heard its community was so great. And over time, I got more and more deeply involved in the community, and eventually I began contributing to it instead of kind of sucking knowledge from it.
That's kind of what the whole open source thing is about, right? Mm-hmm. It's kind of, is that how a lot of people, do you think, get drawn into it? They begin using it, they begin, you know, taking what they can, and then they realize that it's more about giving back as well.
Yeah, I think at some point you realize you went past the event horizon, mm-hmm. and it's time to start giving.
All right. So you spoke today. Are you going to be at the conference tomorrow and Friday?
I will be here all night. I am really busy trying to finish my PhD right now, so I'm not going to be back after tonight.
All right, so if there was one talk that you were going to miss tomorrow, have you looked at the talks tomorrow? Is there anything that piqued your interest?
Let's see.
We've got the schedule right there.
You know what? All the community talks are things I'm really interested in. Mm-hmm. Distributed version control systems I'm very interested in, which is why I was really bummed I had to miss the Git talk today.
You know, they're going to have that on the, I should have mentioned this earlier, but up on the OS Bridge site, they're going to have the complete Git talk soon. So it was streamed earlier, and it will be in its entirety up on the site later.
Oh, great.
So you can get it then.
Actually, today was really the best day for me.
Yeah.
There was a lot of talks I wanted to see about community and about consulting and freelancing. And I'm all about making money because I'm a very broke grad student.
All right. Where can we find you on the internet?
Twitter at dburkholtz. Otherwise, I've got a blog. It's really easy to find if you Google my name.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Donnie, for taking the time to talk to us. Go ahead and sign the board before you leave, and I heard it was a good talk.
All right, thank you. Mm-hmm. Sorry you couldn't make it.
Oh, I was here.